Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya. Here I'm giving you Gospel 11, which is Gnostic Trinity and Exposition of the Parables or Gospel. So I was talking in video 10 about the celestial world, the people who are purely spiritual in nature. They have no physical body, or they can appear and disappear in whatsoever form they want to be. So we can't set any rules because they are purely celestial and they have the same power as God. As Jesus was born with the power of the Holy Spirit, so we cannot explain how he could be born without any normal process. So this again, what we see in purely celestial is all godly, that we cannot explain how Jesus could appear after death to his workers and eat with them and all that, you know, as a normal person. So in God's capacity, he can do whatever he likes. And in India, we have the examples that somebody, a saint, our devotee of God, was meditating and he did not go to his duty. So God himself took his shape, form, and he performed his duties. And when he went to see the person that, "Oh, I'm sorry, I could not come," you know, he said, "But you were there. You were there to doing all your duty and I give you even reward." And such things when you hear, so these things are all celestial world of purely, and these ghosts and other things also belong to this celestial world. But normally some could be harmful, but mostly they are not. So the next one is, we call them birti. Birti means spiritual states. So the people who are once born, they are led by ego, which we call home. And those who are twice born and doubting, they are sensible. So their mind is awakened. Mind that collects information is awakened, so they can collect information as the birds collect. These have strong sensory organs to collect information. So the twice born people are said to be has open mind. They are, the mind is working. We call it in Punjabi man. So the first one is ego is called home and the mind is called man. And those who are sealed to serve God, they are wise men, and we call them buddhi. Buddhi means wisdom. So those who are sealed to serve God, their spiritual state is a wise wisdom or buddhi. And those who are one with God and of thrice born, their spiritual state is called chit. Chit means just the will. So whatever they will, so is done. So whatever they utter from their mouth, so it is done. That means there is no exception. Whatever they say, it is absolute truth. So the people of celestial world, they are non-erring. So we call whatever they imagine in their heart is done. So we call it chitta birti. What is in their heart is taken place. So then we have a next one is mammon. Mammon is needed by the worldly people. So all the people of the celestial world who are leading a family life and worldly affairs, they need mammon. So the once born people, because they are simpleton, they get cheated by the clever people. So they are normally poor. So the rich people thrive over them, and the rich people are like parasite over the poor, and so they thrive over them. So they are, the once born people have less mammon or less money, and they are normally poor. So the twice born people who are awakened, who exploit their mind or man to earn, cheat people, to fleece people, so they can put on different types of garbs, robes, like these bishops and all those people who you see them in churches putting on robes. So they sometimes work for money, and they exploit the once-born people, which are stones. So they put on garbs, and the simple-minded think that he's a religious person. They feed him, they house him, and they buy him a car and all sort of luxuries. So this is called turning stones, the once-born people, into bread. The first temptation of Satan to Christ Jesus. So the next one are the people who are sealed to serve God. Those who are sealed to serve God, so for them mammon is just a means, not an end. To for them the end is God, not the mammon. So they are very simple living, and they are very philanthropic and merciful people. So they give mammon away, that anybody who needs help, they render him help without charging or without any fees. So their lifestyle is simple. So they put on simple clothes, not much silky clothes, are just good to for the weather and for that. So they don't care for the fashion or for beautiful clothes. So the people who are once born, they put on colorful dresses as children are. They like very shining, deep color things, like Peter liked deep color, yellow, red, or other colored dresses, you know, which were more pleasing to eye. Whereas the twice born, like Saint Thomas, he put on simple clothes, but Judas Iscariot, he loved silken clothes. So he put on expensive, and he, when he will eat, he will be very particular, he eat delicious food. And the thrice born, they put on simple clothing, not expensive, just to serve the purpose, that if they are cold, they can put a woolen around it. It could be of any color, they normally light colored and not so humble looking. So these people of the celestial world, they of course are not bothered. So some of them even don't put any clothes even in winter, and in India you can see them, they are naked. So they don't care for the dress, but they put on very simple. They might make a dress of grass to just cover themselves up from cold, but just they don't bother. So they are can be lying naked in the field. So that's why the moral law, they do not apply to the people of the third celestial world, which are the resident of wilderness. Only the people of the world they live are the once born and the twice born people. They live, they form the world, and they obey the moral laws because they are living in this society. And the celestial people, they are above moral laws. So they put on anything they like, and nobody is going to check them, because they live in wilderness. Thank you very much. I hope it make it clear, so we go to the next one. Thank you.